everyone. I'm Tristan Dodd-Gregson, and here with Owen Turnwald. It's Saturday night at Worlds. You don't look super excited.
No, I'm not in too good of a mood. I lost 2 out of my 3 last rounds to just not have like a respectable finish. I mean, I went 4-2 in standard, okay, 5-1 in draft, pretty good, and then I went 3-3 after I started 2-1. So if I had gone 2-0-1 in my last 3 rounds, I would have easily made top 8. But I lost a round, so I knew I was out. I won. And then my last round, I was playing for top 16, and I lost. So,
was it the deck falling apart? Was it bad matchups? Was it people with just the right hate cards? I mean, what did you get matched up against in those last 3 rounds that really did it?
I played against 2 decks that I believe were heavily metagamed against Zoo. I mean, I might say that anyways because I lost because it's just like complaining. But I played against 2 decks. They both had Liliana. They both had Doomblade, Smother, Damnation. The one guy had Deathcloud, and Shuhei had Gifts. So it's like they're both kind of like pretty anti-aggro, black-green, rockish business.
Now, if you had come in with Passive Flames to this event, you would have...
Well, maybe. I mean, they both had Inquisition and Thoughtseize. They both had a large amount of hand disruption. So
these might actually be real decks, then. These aren't just like happen to be aggro, hating.
They're real, but they're only as real as rock can be, you know? Like, you don't want to play a deck that's like... like 100% reactive. It's just all just answers because you're basically going to build a deck that's 40% against any matchup you play against. I mean, they were good against Zoo. I'll give them that. But, I mean, Rock's not usually my style. I usually like to play something a little more proactive because when people will keep bad hands or they'll mulligan or they'll misplay, when you're doing something aggressive and putting the pressure on them, it's just way better.
All right, well, let's take us back to the beginning of this weekend. How has this Worlds as an experience been for you?
Oh, it was awesome. It was fun. And nothing makes me happier than seeing Raptor, Conley, LSV, and Paulo all make the top 8. I mean, as far as I know, we've never had a Pro Tour where there's 4 people of Channel Fireball in the top 8.
Came close in Paris, didn't we?
No, in Paris there was 1, Ben Stark. 2 if you count Tom Martel.
What did... Oh, yeah, Reitzel didn't make it.
Yeah. Reitzel... I don't know if he used Channel Fireball then or not.
Yeah,
I have no idea. I'm not his agent.
He did not play the team deck.
Yeah. In top 16, there was Ifro in 9th, LSV in 10th, me in 12th. So it was like real near misses for all of us. But
so in a way, for the team, this event really made up for that and went beyond it.
Oh, smashing success. And we didn't even have Cobblade. We played with Tempered Steel, with the Edge Champion straight from the Dime Binder or whatever.
Now, was that standard choice, was it loose at all? Or was it
no,
just...
it was good. I mean, I didn't love it, but I might have just been on the wrong end of the variance spectrum for that.
Now, you 4-2'd?
I went 4-2, okay. But it just felt like a struggle. Like, I mean, I had underpowered cards and just weird hands. Like, a lot of times if you don't get Metalcraft, your cards just don't work. So if you have, like, Etch Champion, but you... Like, a lot of opening hands I would get were, like, Mox, Etch Champion, Tempered Steel, like, 3 lands with, like, Glint Hawk, and you're just like, this hand is just, like, weird and not a lot of synergy. But then other times you watch people and they go, like, land, Signal Pest, Memnite, Mox Opal, Spellbomb, next turn Tempered Steel, and it's just the game's just over. So the deck, I think, is a good choice, but it was so-so for me.
Now, Player of the Year race. Mm-hmm. I don't want to sound like the guy that doomed you, but you didn't get too much ground. You didn't do too much for yourself this weekend. You get 3 points, 4 points?
I don't actually know how many points I get, but I'm basically going to fall in, like, 40th place or something. I was in 23rd, and I lost. What?
Sorry.
Why is that funny?
I thought you were talking about Player of the Year standings.
Oh, no. But
because you often exaggerate in such a fashion.
No. But in this tournament, I was in like 23rd and I lost. So there's no chance of me making... That's the thing. In this last round, if I had won, I would make top 16. If I lose, I make top 50. So it's just like such a huge swing. I would be more comfortable if I could lose and still make top 32. But it's just like now it's just like... The huge disappointment of our tournament overall.
So who may jump you?
Luis and Paulo. They both have a very legitimate shot. Again, I haven't done the math to see exactly who, what position they need to make to pass me, because frankly, it's just not that important to me. But I know Paulo and Luis, I know for a fact if either one of them makes top 4, they win. There's a very slight chance that just making top 8 beats me, but I don't think so.
Fair. So looking back, I mean, end of competition for you here now, would you have made any changes as far as deck choices or draft choices?
I mean, when it comes to brass tacks, I'm always just going to trust the team, you know? There's no way that we're going to make a huge mistake where we're just way off because there's just too many people. And there's no way that five people are going to sit by and let something just embarrassing happen and just let everybody else pick a bad deck and lose, you know? If somebody believes that deck X is the best deck in the format, they're going to fight to convince everyone else because they know that if the tables were flipped, they would fight to convince them. They would not sit by and let them make a mistake.
Makes you guys work. So many of you are strong opinionated. I mean, even Webb will speak up when you need him to about a deck. So you get a little time off then, about 4 weeks, really, before you have to worry about Magic again.
Yep.
Next competition is just Orlando or what?
I don't actually know.
There you go. Take the time off.
Yeah.
Just record some drafts. Enjoy yourself.
Yeah.
Fair enough. Any parting words for the audience if this is the last interview we have this year?
Nothing other than keep watching Magic TV.
Wow. A nice sentiment. Yeah. Nothing. All right. I'll take it. Thank you, Owen. Thanks for being here. Still a great year for you.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
All right. That's good. Keep setting the bar higher.
Well, it's like, yeah, it was an awesome year, but it's like I didn't have any Grand Prix wins, I didn't have any Pro Tour top eights, and I'm not going to win Player of the Year. So in 6 months, everybody's just going to forget, and it'll be fine.
You're no Brad. Come on.
Yeah, how could I ever hope to be?
you're at the very least a funny asterisk in Rhys Hagen's stats book. Like,
I'm sure this is all going to get edited out.
No way. In 2011, Owen Turnwald made...
He did pretty good, but seven. Yeah. He's got there's no grinder book, but he's okay, I guess.
Oh, there's no grind. What would the Owen book be called?
I don't know.
Just insults, just in the slight italics by Owen Turnwell.
Nobody would write it. There's no way there's enough people actually interested in a book about me to actually buy it for it to be worth the time you would spend to write it.
There's nowhere that theory's been tested. Fair. Well, thank you for being here. Spectacular year. Glad to hear aspirations are still higher for next year. Check out Owen's content on Channel Fireball all the time. Great articles, better videos, because again, it's Owen and he gets to do what he does. And thanks for watching.
Yep.